I just came from the movie theater where I saw Public Enemies, the Michael Mann digital film, which I managed to miss in screenings over and over again, quite to my irritation. Big Michael Mann fan, very accepting into the digital work. So for me, the whole idea of it was intriguing. What was he going to do with a period movie that was shot digitally? How would it affect it? Would it really matter? Would it change the dynamic? And it was a fascinating experience. I think the movie is very interesting. There are parts of it I love. There are parts of it I thought were kind of flawed almost because of the format. But what fascinated me about the film, what the parts that I really adored about the film, were that there was an intimacy created by the way he shoots on digital that really doesn't come across on film. There's something about the gloss of film that makes it feel like a movie. And there's something about the intimacy of the way he uses video that we've seen Johnny Depp perform now in a way we've never seen anywhere else. I mean, there is a sense of the what's going on in his eye, the color of his eye, the layers of his eyes, and behind his eyes that I don't feel like I've seen in other movies. And, you know, even the texture of his skin, the texture of his stubble, the very, very subtle little things that he does, I feel like Mann captured those, and Dante Spinetti, with a remarkable skill and beauty. And that's what's great about this movie. Public Enemies is an intimate story about people, both in the love sequences, the romantic sequences with him and the terribly miscast, still wonderful, but terribly miscast, Marion Cotillard. And I'll explain that in a second. But also with Christian Bale. I mean, whenever you're in a quiet moment with characters who are considering things, it pops through the screen in a way that we really don't see. I mean, even in the great films, the French films that are meant to be intimate and intense and are very quiet and thoughtful, that is a kind of filmmaking, and I'm not discounting the great value of those films, but in a way, the video does reach past it. What the video doesn't reach past is the ability to do action sequences and movement of the camera, where this camera, I'm not sure even what he used, but it just doesn't get it. It doesn't bring the kind of a frame going across a screen in a hurry on this digital camera does not give you that kind of beautiful pan that a film camera does. And I'm not really sure whether that's because he's not using a different kind of camera or whether the digital technology just isn't there yet or whether he has to light still. I mean, even in some of the intimate scenes, you can tell that he's lighting very brightly from one side in order to get the digital image the way he wants to get it. So I don't know what the answer to that is. So, and those sequences, some of them have got brilliant moments. They have beautiful images. I mean, you took still frames from this picture. Almost every action sequence, there's stuff that's absolutely gorgeous and fantastic. I don't see the relationship to Bonnie and Clyde. I mean, I see it in the broader picture. I don't think this is a knockoff of that in some way, a digital Bonnie and Clyde, because Bonnie and Clyde was the visual violence of Bonnie and Clyde. In that case, the medium was the message. Doing that was a powerful thing of its time. In this movie, it's actually, though it's very violent and there are people shot and there's blood and all that, it's not done in a way that's meant to exaggerate the violence or to particularly obsess on the violence. It's much more interested in what the violence does to people, physically and otherwise. But physically, you know, the realistic nature of what happens when a gunshot hits you or a gun blast hits you is much more what this movie's after than something like Bonnie and Clyde, where the intensity of that moment is what he's chasing. And really, from beginning to end. Marion Cotillard, as I said, completely miscast because the character is not French. Has French ancestry. She looks perfect for it. But the accent was distracting and seemingly incorrect. I mean, this is a movie that's obsessed with detail, and yet she has this accent. She's from the Midwest. Yes, her mother was French, but and her father was Indian, or vice versa. Or maybe her father was French and her mother was Indian. In any case, the whole half-breed thing, Marion Cotillard was the beautiful choice to do that. And she also, later in the film you'll see, reflects Myrna Loy on some level. But the accent is not an American accent. I mean, there's just no getting away with it. No matter how much studying she did, there's still that French thing. It's not an Indian accent. It's not a Midwestern accent. It is just French trying not to be so French. And it's a problem, ultimately, for that character, in my opinion. Lovely performance, well done, but, you know, it just, every time she spoke, it kind of took me out of it a bit. Other performances, I mean, this movie is chock filled with Michael Mann people. As always, he finds new people. John Ortiz, playing another kind of character that we've never really seen him play before, is terrific in this movie. But a lot of performances and a lot of people who you probably won't recognize, who are new people, give really strong, solid performances. Mann is not scared of casting, and he's really good at picking people who are going to emerge that way. So overall, I'd say it is a great film for cineasts. It is a film for adults. It is a film for people who are interested in taking that journey. I mean, it's not a rock'em sock'em movie, and I did think about the whole Moneyball situation during it, and I thought, you know, this is kind of what Sony is saying they would like to avoid with Moneyball, which is that instead of it being a romp and, you know, gunplay and Johnny Depp being, you know, all charm all the time, it is an intimate movie about people who are serious. I don't think it's existential, you know, whatever. I do think there is an element of the good guys are bad guys and bad guys are good guys thing. But I think that's natural to the beast, and I think in some ways, actually, the screenplay and Mann's direction do not actually chase that, which is probably the right choice because it's been done so many times. And it's been done by Mann so many times. He just lets it be, and he just lets the audience participate in what happens and, you know, have their own experience as they go along. So I think it's a very respectful film of adults. Some kids might like it too. But overall, I think a very good film. Not a big summer home run movie. Probably belongs in the summer, but it probably belonged in August. And as far as Johnny Depp action movies go, it's not one. You know, it's not even a movie like Open Windows or Rear Windows or Dog Window, whatever that thing, that bad movie he made, you know, right after he kind of got very hot. It's not that either. It's just, you know, it's an adult drama that tells a great historic story and a moment in history in a time where, you know, like The Godfather, the mob is figuring out that there's more money to be made by being a little less bloody. It's a story about eras changing. For me, an interesting film that I'm sure I'll go see again and look forward to. It's not Heat. It's not trying to be Heat. At moments, it's got some of the, you know, the intimate moments of Heat are there, and some of them actually work better. And I'd say the relationship between De Niro and Brenneman in Heat, this relationship with Dillinger and Miss Cotillard works better. So in some way, he's improved on Heat in some sections, but it's not the action movie that Heat was, doesn't want to be, isn't trying to top Batman's, you know, bank sequence, which kind of was stolen from Heat, or The Dark Knights, rather. It's just a very strong, dramatic movie. On a very big scale, with a very interesting question about how we choose to see digital cinema versus celluloid cinema, and how it affects us, and how it can affect us, and how it will affect us. It's still in transition. This is still a moment in between things, and I think this movie is another step, which Mann has been really one of the big movers on, towards a cinema where that line is blurred and gone, and we're just watching the images and not worrying about what the details of those images are outside of the beauty of them individually. So, interesting movie.